To protect our water resources, it is important to purify water prior to discharge. Soluble and insoluble particles and organics, as well as other pollutants, need to be removed to meet legislated targets. Nature provides its own purification mechanisms, which can be physical, chemical, or biological. But these systems are not sufficient to control the large pollution volumes that man produces. Man-made wastewater treatment systems have a dual function to remove solids from the water, as well as clean the water to the required water quality standards. The steps involved depend on the pollutants present in the water, but include various unit operations, each with specific goals in the process. These wastewater treatment plants typically take up large areas and process large amounts of industrial or municipal wastewaters. Purified water typically flows into natural water sources while the solids are collected and removed. Wastewater treatment can be broken up into physical, biological, or chemical means. Additionally, wastewater treatment is often spoken about as primary, secondary, or tertiary treatment. Primary treatment is what happens at the start of the process, such as screening to remove large objects or relying on settling or sedimentation to occur. You could also involve coagulation or flocculation where, through the addition of chemicals, larger particles are formed, which would make physical separation easier. Secondary treatment may also include physical methods, as well as biological treatment techniques. Any remaining soluble organics can be consumed aerobically or anaerobically and removed. Two types of microbial growth can occur, either through biofilm growth, where water flows over the microorganisms, or as suspended growth, where the microorganisms flow with the water during treatment. When aerobic conditions are required, aeration tanks such as these might be used as a secondary treatment method. An activated sludge process with many microorganisms can remove a large amount of organic matter. There are several types of biological treatment systems, including biofilters, activated sludge processes, rotating contactors, or fluidized beds. These methods can be simple and have a lower cost, but can be less effective on highly toxic compounds. The final step in wastewater treatment, the tertiary treatment, utilizes activated carbon, zeolites, or synthetic resins as a means to treat the water. This tertiary treatment step could involve recarbonation by adding lime or disinfection to destroy any unwanted microorganisms. Disinfection often involves adding chlorine as a solid or a gas to kill harmful microorganisms, but can also be used for taste and odor control. The chlorine may have residual properties to fight contamination well after the wastewater treatment system. Other disinfection alternatives include chloroamines, chloride dioxide, ozone, and UV. Solids that result from the wastewater treatment process are often dewatered and thickened. They can be treated by chemical precipitation and filtration and are often digested anaerobically. Solid waste can be landfilled, incinerated, or used for other applications, depending on the geographic location of the facility as well as other factors.